Sitting right in front of us, I have this gorgeous lineup of model train cars ready to be unboxed. Yes, they are unboxed, but this is post the unboxing. During the unboxing, I came across an issue with this car in particular. It had a section of applied detail part broken off. It's not that big of a deal to repair. It's nothing to worry about. So as some bonus content at the end of this video, I'll show you what I did to fix, repair, and get this car back into service on the layout. So let's get that unboxing video started right now. For being expedient on the video, I've already cut open the box and opened it. So I'll show you what's inside there. We got our card. I got an Atlas item. Another Atlas item. A Micro Trains. And dump this thing out here. And a Graffiti 4-pack. This is what I've been waiting on. First model we'll look at is an Atlas Masterline freight car. It is a carbon black car, so we'll pop it out. Here it is. It looks like it's got etched metal detail on the top, body mount couplers, and metal wheel sets. And loads and loads of detail on the bottom. The hard part in displaying this model is it is black. It is hard to see, but it is a very nice model. It is an activated carbon car, so it does have some cool features like side ports and everything for sampling. Pointed out, it's got metal wheel sets, body mount couplers. It has extreme and well done underbody detail, brake lines, air cylinders. It just looks really nice. Too bad most of the time you'll never see the bottom of it, but it is well done. The lettering on the side of the car is extremely well done and clear. Even under magnification, you can easily read the lettering and see no issues with this. It's well done. Again, it's really small. It's N-scale, but it's well done. We're done looking at the Atlas N-scale Masterline freight car, 4180 Airslide covered hopper. Let's have a look at the Atlas N-scale Masterline freight car. It's an Illinois Central Golf covered hopper. It's a very nice looking car. All the lettering and numbering on it looks nice and clear and easy to read. It does have minimal underbody work. It does have plastic wheel sets and truck mounted couplers. The roofing detail is just plain plastic with normal hatches. It's a good quality operator car, in my opinion. After a quick look at this, I'll call this another nice car from Atlas. It's not the best in detail, but it will be perfectly functional in my grain train. An Atlas N-scale Masterline freight car. Pullman Standard 4427 3-bay covered hopper, marked in Illinois Central Golf livery. The next model I have to look at is a 3-bay covered hopper for Micro Train lines, marked for Penn Central. This model has minimal underbody detail, which is typical for this model for Micro Train lines. It has truck mounted couplers, plastic wheel sets, which still operate very well for Micro Train's line. This model is also equipped with what I call the industry standard of couplers. It is a Micro Train Lines magnetic coupler. Just a great coupler and great for operations. Other things to note on this model are the roof hatches are glued in place but separately applied. It does have a walkway on it, but it is not brass etched. It's just your standard plastic walkway, but it's still highly functional for the grain train I'll be putting it in. And all in all, it's a fairly nice model that will blend well within my grain train. If you know anything about me, I'm a big fan of the weathered and graffitied cars. The problem is my layout is so large and I have so much to do, I don't have the time to sit down and weather and graffiti cars. MicroTrain Lines has done these weathered and graffitied cars in advance. They have some issues, but other than that, they're really great. They make it easy to get a nice realistic look on your layout. Or if you have time, I'm a big fan of a couple channels that do weathering and graffiti. In fact, if you look right up here in this corner, I provided a link to one of my favorite channels that I do watch for weathering and graffiti. Let's have a look inside the box. Look at that. There the four cars are. We'll pop them out and they come in your standard MicroTrain Lines box or N-scale box. So let's open them up. So we'll start with this one. Pop it out. Here it is. It's a basic Santa Fe covered hopper, weathered and rusty on each side. With the car being weathered, I'm not too concerned about going in and checking to make sure all the letters are perfectly clear. It's weathered, so they will be smudged over and dirty. But what we will have a look at, we'll take a look at the bottom, and in typical MicroTrains fashion, the detail is pretty much non-existent. But it's an N-scale car and we're not looking at the bottom normally. It does have truck mounted couplers, but they're MicroTrain line couplers, which means they are perfect for operations. The car does have plastic roof walks and separately applied roof hatches, but it's adequate for an N-scale style operator car. Now we'll look at number two. In this car is more of a dirty wash. Kind of hard to tell whether it started out as gray or brown. Turn it around. We do have a little graffiti on the other side of it. Looks pretty good. Adequate, and I think it'll look nice on the layout. I will hit these cars with some dull coat spray on them. The next car, and I noticed that the roof walk has come off. So we have to look at that. Let's pop it out of the box. So the roof hatch has fallen off. We will fix this in a minute. Let's just see if it snaps back into place. Nothing a little glue will fix. And this kind of stuff does happen. Let me put it away. Now this does show the fact that it does have real separately applied roof hatches. It came off. But let's look at the sides. That's what we're here for, is the graffiti work. It's dark. It's actually really dark, but it still looks good. A little dull coat would clean it up. And this here is the money side. And it looks really good. This would look really nice on the layout. So very nice looking model. This is the final car in this set. Nice graffiti on it. It does have the streaking weathering effect on the side. Looking at the top of the car, one of the things I do like is the fact that the colors are different along the roof walk, showing that panels have been replaced. Still, it's a piece of plastic, but it looks good, and in a moving train, I think that will look really neat. That's a cool effect. And the opposite side is just standard streaking. So I think that's a good looking little car. Now in the end, I really like this set. Would I recommend this set? Yes, I would. And I think it will look good on anybody's modern layout. So that is a really nice set for MicroTrain Lines. I'm looking forward to get this stuff on the layout and running. This is the N-scale Micro Train Lines, Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe. Weathered car set 993-05-550. And this is a really nice little car from that box set. The roof hatch on this model has come off during shipping. This will not be a hard repair to do. It's just basically a little bit of glue. I'm gonna use Zap PT56 Canopy Glue Formula 560. If you want to, follow the link down below on the comment section and you can purchase your own bottle from Amazon.com. And we'll take care of this really quick, and it's not a big deal to fix little small problems like this. So I'm gonna take a dot of this stuff, put it on a post-it note, don't need much, pick it up with just any tool. We'll bring it around here and I'll just wrap it around the edge of the roof hatch. Enough to stick it. Take our panel, line it up, and drop it in place. A little squeeze here. There we go, pushed it in. Take the glue and kind of just smear it along the edge here. This canopy glue dries clear. For what I'm doing here, it really does not need to be super glued, it just needs to be held in place. In fact, I'm going to wipe off the excess with the edge of a post-it note. Let's see if I can get that. Maybe not get the excess. I'll give this a little bit of drying time and it should clear itself up really nicely. And it's ready to throw on the track and run. So that's all that's needed to fix something like that. Don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. It is called a model for a reason. Sometimes you gotta put the parts back on it. And it is a hobby. Enjoy the hobby and take care of your equipment. As you can see, the canopy glue has dried clear. It's time to put this on the layout and run it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. And I have some extra videos for you to watch here and here, so go check them out. And as always, stay frosty, my friends. Oh, and there'll be some run-bys running here in just a second.